Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In today's video, we will learn alter command in SQL Server. Using alter command, we can do many things, like we can add column in the existing table, we can change the data type of the existing field within the table, or we can drop the column from the table, or we can rename the column and we can drop the key as well. In this way, we can use alter command in many ways. So let's see all these commands. So yeah, let me create one table. And let's add here ID column as integer. And let's add another column called employee name. Let's leave it as an worker. And let's save this table. And let's add a primary key in this table. And now let's save this table. Now let me give it name as a employee master. Now let's first select the data from this table. And here we can see we have table with the two columns. Now let's try to add field in this existing table. For that we can use the alter command. So that is alter table. Then we have to provide the table name, that is employee master. And then we can provide just add and the field name, that is gender. And we can provide the data type, let's say for now integer. Let me execute this command, and here you can see we have added gender field successfully in the data table. So let me execute this select statement once again, and here you can see we have three fields in this table. Now let's move on to the next command, that is alter the data type. So using the alter data type, we can change the data type of the existing field within the table. So let's say for now, the gender we have as an integer in this table. Let me refresh the tables list and let me select this table, employee master, and let's open it in a design window. And here we can see gender field is added as a data type integer. Now let's try to change this integer data type to varchar. For that we can use the alter command, alter table, and the table name employee master. Then we have to provide the alter column name, so that is alter column name gender, and we want to change it to the varchar. So now let's start to execute this, and command executed successfully. Now let me close this window and let me open this employee master table in design window once again. And now this time we can see gender has the data type varchar. Now let's try to rename this field gender. So for that we can use the system stored procedure available by SQL Server. So the stored procedure name is sp underscore rename, and then we had, since we have to execute it, so we have to provide the execute keyword, and then we have to provide the exact path of the field that we want to rename. So that is employee master dot gender, and let me add the schema as well just to avoid any conflict with the employee master table within the other schema as well. And after that, the next parameter we have to provide the new column name for this field. So this time let me make it as a sex. Then we have to provide the what is the object type. So for that we can provide this is a column, and let me execute this stored procedure. And here we can see the command has executed successfully. Now let me select this table once again. And here we can see the gender has gone and it has been renamed to the sex now. Now the next command is the drop column. For that we can just simply alter the table, and this time we can just add drop column. And we have to provide the column name. So now since we have renamed this column to the sex, so let me make it as a sex. And let's execute this. Command executed successfully. Now let's select the data from this table, and here you can see we have only two columns now, and the sex field has been removed from the table. Now the last command is the drop key command. So for that, let me refresh this list of tables just to get the latest scheme of the table. And under this table, let's go to the keys. And here you can see we have a key defined within this table, that is employee master. And now let's say we want to delete this key from this table. For that we have to use alter table, table name, then drop constraint. And then we have to provide the constraint name. And that's it. Let's execute this command. And command executed successfully. So now let me refresh this table. And now let's go to the keys. And we should not get any key over here. And as expected, we can see the keys folder is blank and we don't have any key for this table now. So in this way, we can use alter command to use with multiple different commands like add a column or rename or drop. And just to add as a tip, for a couple of commands where the syntax here might be changed as compared to the other databases. So for example, for rename. So here we use the stored procedure, but in other databases like MySQL or Oracle, there we can use the same alter command like alter table. And then we have to provide the table name. And then we have to use the keyword rename column. Then we have to provide the column name. So let's say gender to, and what is the new name? Let's say sex. So in this way, we can use this command with the other databases, but here since in SQL Server, it has system stored procedure available. So we can use the stored procedure rename for this renaming purpose. So this is all for this video. I hope now you have learned the alter command in SQL Server, and we'll see you in the next video.